Now, just back from campaigning in New Hampshire, Republican presidential candidate John Hentzman. Good to have you with us this morning, sir.
Delighted to be with you. Thanks for having me.
Let's talk about some of those polls, because we just saw some of the numbers there. It's got to be a little discouraging to see that you're not breaking through both nationally and in some of the polls in New Hampshire. The Gallup poll has you polling at about 2%. Why are you not breaking through?
Well, first of all, I can think of some presidents in the past who have done pretty well in the end when they were polling very low at this point in the race. If the election were next month, I guess that would be cause for concern. Yeah. The fact of the matter is we've got a long way to go. We've been in this race for 1 month. It's about the early building blocks that have to be put in the early states like New Hampshire, South Carolina, and Florida. It's about rallying around your message that is about expanding the economy and creating jobs and getting this country moving again. But that's going to take a little while, and we're in the early days. Dog days of summer.
But you do have to kind of get out of the blocks quickly.
Of course.
And I think it would be safe to say that you haven't gotten out of the blocks the way you would have liked.
We've announced, we've organized, we've got the a terrific presence in the early states, so that's exactly where we wanted to be. Nobody's going to pay any attention to this race until you're into September, October, and by then we'll have the organization on the ground. We will have a message honed that is absolutely in keeping with what we did as governor of the state of Utah. Yeah. And that is moving this country to a position of competitiveness and job creation that everybody knows is possible.
Well, one of the major themes of this campaign, as we know, is going to be the economy. The focus right now for most Americans is Washington and what is not being done on both sides of the aisle by the people they put in those jobs there. You just came out in support of Speaker Boehner's plan, although we just learned from the Congressional Budget Office it doesn't really add up to the amount of deficit reduction he initially said it would. A number of Republicans are not behind that plan. The Wall Street Journal headline this morning was rebellion. Why do you think Speaker Boehner's plan is the right way to go?
Because it's the only act in town. We've got to remember that we're still 25% of the world's GDP. We're still the country that everyone in the world looks to for leadership and financial leadership. We've got to find a solution here. And I think Speaker Boehner's solution is right on. It cuts where we need to cut. He talks about tax reform, where we desperately need it as a country. He talks about a balanced budget amendment, which we're going to need. Every governor in this country has a balanced budget amendment. It's the best safeguard that we can have up in spending. And he's looking at entitlements as well over time. It's a two-step process, to be sure, but I think it is the best solution on the table right now.
Is there any concern about one of the steps being that there would have to be another vote, of course, and this would happen during the election cycle? This is a major issue right now. Do you want to face it again during the campaign?
Listen, I think the people of this country need to provide their stamp of approval, their imprimatur, if you will, in terms of how these cuts are made, in terms of entitlement reform, in terms of tax reform, a balanced budget amendment. These are all key issues. And let's face it, the good news, and there is some good news that is coming out of all of this. These are huge issues that we have not discussed before as a country, yet they're coming to a head. And I have every reason to think that for the first time in recent history, we're going to be embracing some aspects of financial management, tax policy that we have long needed, and now people are talking about in a serious vein for the first time. That's good for this country. If it takes us two steps to get there, so be it. But first, we've got to meet our financial obligations.
When you announced that you were going to run for president, one of the things that you said at Liberty State Park there was that the political discourse is corrosive right now. You've changed your philosophy a little in that you're now starting to go on the attack a little bit more, although you did say civility and the high road, that was the path you were going to take. Do you need to take some shots at Mitt Romney, at President Obama, to really get noticed?
Listen, civility can coexist with the facts.
Yeah.
In a race, you've got to point out your differences. You've got to put your record on the table. You know, our state, Utah, which was the number one job creator while I was governor, against states governed by others that were way behind. You've got to compare and contrast. I think that's completely fair. You can proceed in a way that's respectful, that takes the high road in terms of how you deal with these issues. Nobody wants to, you know, rip down somebody's integrity. It's the personal attacks that I think Americans hate so much about politics these days. Stick to the issues. Mm-hmm. You can talk about the issues. You can draw your differences. That's totally fair, and we're going to do that.
Governor, we got to go, though, but thanks so much.
It's an honor.
Good.
Thank you.
We'll be right back. This is The Early Show.